Hello friends, welcome to RSNIS. I have started a web TV. You can access the videos at tv.rsnis.com. There is a highlight program of this channel. The name of that program is Transform into an IAS Officer in 100 Days. There are 100 episodes, each of 3-hour duration. If you watch those 100 episodes, definitely you can crack this exam. Very easily you can crack IAS exam. Friends, if you can believe, you may start, but if you can understand, you will achieve. I am starting with polity here. You know, I have divided Indian polity into 5 parts: Constitution, Union Government, State and Local Governments, Bodies, and Miscellaneous Concepts. If you do not know these, please go and watch the syllabus of polity module. Now, I will start with Constitution. I further divide this into subparts. First we will see Preamble, Union and Territory, Citizenship, Fundamental Rights, DPSP, Fundamental Duties, then Features of Constitution and Amendment Procedure. So I divide this Constitution part into 6 subparts. Now we will start with Preamble. This is an important topic and very simple topic, hardly it takes 20 minutes. What we are going to learn here? I am going to give you very basic concepts. First we will see the introduction of Preamble, what is Preamble we try to understand. Then we will see the text of Preamble, what is written in Preamble we will see, and Preamble versus Supreme Court. What are the judgments that came regarding Preamble in Supreme Court? What it has told, whether it is part of Constitution or not, what Supreme Court has told, we understand this. So the 3 concepts we learn here. Okay, so first I will start with the first concept. That is introduction. Very basic points, and bar bar exam mein aata rehta hai in various exams, not only IAS exam, even state exams and choti moti exams mein bhi bahut bar aata hai. So you better understand this. First I would like to tell you, the American Constitution was the first to have preamble. You see, now today many countries, many constitutions have preamble, but the one to start with is the American Constitution. So understand this, choti moti exams ke liye, the American Constitution was the first to have preamble. Hope you got it. See, it's a fact. So nothing to take serious, easily you can understand. Now if you see, kya humne preamble pehle baar hamara constitution mein aaya hai ya kabhi pehle bhi hamara history mein dekha hai, agar aisa kahin aata hai, so Government of India Act 1919 also had preamble. Suppose choti exams mein puch sakta hai, which of the following act had preamble? So aisa kahi aata hai, it was Government of India 1919 Act. But there was no preamble in Government of India 1935 Act, which came after 1919. So in the legislative history of India, for the first time, the Government of India Act 1919, which were also called as Montague-Chelmsford reforms. We sare hum modern history mein padhenge. ओके, अभी आप इतना डीप में मत जाइए, इतना समझ लीजिए 1919 गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एक्ट में प्रीएम्बल थे, बट बाद में 35 में दोबारा नहीं थे. ओके, सो इट हैड ए सेपरेट प्रीएम्बल. हाउएवर गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एक्ट 1935 हैड नो प्रीएम्बल. होप यू अंडरस्टैंड. फॉर स्मॉल एग्जाम्स आई एम गिविंग दिस, मे बी व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एक्ट हैड प्रीएम्बल. सो 1919 1909 1935, व्हेन सच थिंग्स आर देयर, 1919. Okay, so US Constitution was the first to have preamble, and 1919 Act may be hamara history mein preamble the, but 1935 mein nahi the. Here it was there and 1935 it was not there. Got it? Next, sudden, you know, this is very important. Bahut log bahut bola hai preamble ke bare mein. We understand what is this preamble. So the mind of the makers of the Constitution is reflected in the preamble. Like what kind of constitution they wanted to make, that idea or those requirements, those were you know, you can find those in preamble. So the mind of the constitution makers, you can find it here in the preamble. Or you can say preamble contains the real objective and philosophy of the constitution makers. See, all are different ways of saying the same thing. So the mind is reflected in the preamble, the mind of the constitution maker, or the philosophy of the constitution makers, mind, philosophy, or the objective, whatever you call. So it is all reflected in the preamble. नहीं समझ में आया कोई बात नहीं, दो मिनट के बाद आपको समझ में आएगा. Now if you see, preamble contains the summary or essence of the constitution. Again the same. So it reflects the philosophy of the constitution makers. That means what kind of constitution they wanted to make. That is what is being mentioned in the preamble. That means obviously it contains the essence of the constitution. Getting me? All are different words saying the same thing. Even if you see, it refers to the introduction or preface to the constitution. Preface kya hota hai? Generally what is it about? So aisa cheez diya jata hai. So it is all about it. So preface, or you can say introduction, or mind of the constitution maker, or philosophy of the constitution makers, or you can say summary of the constitution, or essence of the constitution, kahi bhi, or the objective of the constitution makers, ye sab yaha bhi aata hai, sahi hai. So preamble represents all this. Hope you are getting me. Now you see, different people, जो constituent assembly का members, जो कुछ important लोग इसके बारे में क्या बोला, वे IAS के लिए नहीं, छोटी मोटी exams में आ सकता है, इसलिए मैं बता रहा हूँ. Like preamble is political horoscope of Indian constitution. K M Munshi ने बोला ये बात. Means छोटी exams के लिए सिर्फ. Okay. अभी याद नहीं होगा कोई बात नहीं, बाद में हो जाएगा आराम से. So you can ignore it also. So preamble is political horoscope of Indian constitution told by K. M. Munshi. It is the soul of constitution by Thakur Das Bhargava. These are all members of constituent assembly. Okay. So identity card of the constitution. Palkiwala ne bola. So identity card, or this is more important. Identity card wala. So who told this? N.A. Palkiwala. Choti moti exams, state exams mein aata hai. Is tarah ki questions. IAS में आने का चांस बहुत कम है, बट आजकल क्या हो रहा है, बहुत स्टेट एग्जाम्स की क्वेश्चंस कॉपी पेस्ट कर रहा है IAS वाला भी, because he became lazy, he is not making new questions. Like if you see 2017 paper, 34 या 35 questions were reality copied from various previous exams, previous papers. I'm not saying only IAS previous papers से कॉपी किया, it could be from CDS, or it could be from NDA, or from ESE, or from CAPF, or from some state exams like that. ये सिर्फ 17 में नहीं, 16 में भी ऐसा हुआ, 15 में भी हुआ, हर साल होता है, common, because यही तो paper setters है ना, यही तो बनाएगा, so most of them are, you know, what they know, they keep giving it in various exams. So you keep it in mind, identity card of the constitution, preamble. So Bhargava ने बोला, soul of the constitution, Thakur Das Bhargava, political horoscope of Indian constitution, K.M. Munshi. Hope you understand. Now you see what happened actually. The preamble to the constitution is based on the objectives resolution drafted and moved by Jawaharlal Nehru. If you see, before making the constitution, वे यहाँ का concept नहीं है, making of the constitution करके मैं miscellaneous topics में fifth part में समझाऊंगा detail में. पहले बनाया constitution बनाने से पहले, how should we make the constitution? What are the objectives? क्या है, व्हाट इज द रिक्वायरमेंट, ये समझ लेंगे. ऑब्जेक्टिव्स क्या समझ आएगा, तभी तो ऐसा बन जाएगा ना, सब सबको एक कॉमन ऑब्जेक्टिव होना चाहिए. सो द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स रिजोल्यूशन करके दे हैव ड्राफ्टेड ऑल दोस ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. सो दैट वाज मूव्ड बाय पंडित नेहरू, एक्चुअली मूव्ड इन 1946 13 दिसंबर, एंड इट वाज अडॉप्टेड बाय द कंस्टिट्यूएंट असेंबली ऑन 22 जनवरी 1947. फिलहाल के लिए परेशान मत होना ये डेट से, जस्ट इतना वर्ड समझ लेना. ऑब्जेक्टिव्स रिजोल्यूशन डिटेल में हम बात करेंगे फिफ्थ पार्ट में. So preamble was made out of this. So it is based on this. पहले objectives बनाया, so preamble में भी यही बताएगा ना, अभी भी मैं बताऊंगा, text बताऊंगा तो आपको समझ में आएगा, वहां भी यही है. What is the objectives, or what is the nature of the state, वही तो बताया है वहां भी. So it is based on the objectives resolution. कहीं question आता है preamble is based on the objectives resolution statement आता है तो सही है. Hope you understand this. So that's why it is the basic of the political system, preamble. So it guided the constitution making process. So because of the objectives ye bana hai, so it was the thing which was in the mind of the constitution makers while making different articles, while framing the constitution. जब बनाने टाइम पे एक ऑब्जेक्ट कॉमन गोल होता है, ओके ऐसा बनाना है तो ऐसा. सपोज यू नो एक सपोज एक फैमिली का एक वैल्यू है, तो जो भी एक्शन लेने से टाइम पे हम ये मेन आइडिया को माइंड में रख के हम हमारा बिहेवियर रहता है, राइट। सो सपोज आई शुड, दीज आर माय एथिक्स, आई शुड नॉट गो बियॉन्ड, सो देन ऑब्वियसली माय एक्शंस विल बी बेस्ड ऑन माय एथिक्स। Similarly, my way of framing the constitution will be based on my objectives or my goal, or that is what is called preamble. Getting me? So it has guided, preamble has guided the constitution makers to frame that constitution. Hope you are getting all this. But if you see, the preamble is neither a source of power to legislature nor a prohibition upon the powers of legislature. इसका मतलब ये है, means it is not non-justiciable. ऐसा नहीं जो प्रियम्बल में लिखा है उसके लिए कोर्ट में जाए, सो दैट इज प्रोविजंस आर नॉट एनफोर्सेबल इन कोर्ट्स ऑफ लॉ। गेटिंग मी? सो दिस इज ऑल व्हाट यू नीड टू नो अबाउट प्रियम्बल। डोंट वरी, कुछ क्वेश्चन देखेंगे तो कुछ समझ में आएगा। नाउ लेट मी टेक सम क्वेश्चंस व्हिच वर आस्क्ड इन वेरियस पेपर्स। एबीपीएससी 2011 में एक क्वेश्चन आया है, व्हिच पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन रिफ्लेक्ट्स द माइंड एंड आइडियल्स ऑफ द फ्रेमर्स। So obviously preamble, mind and ideals or objectives or the goal or the main philosophy of the constitution, ये सारे पहले preamble में है, तभी बना ना। So it is in preamble. Getting me? Very basic question asked in APPSC. The same question again came in civil services 2017. इस साल जो वहाँ से उठा के दिया है। Actually ये question और भी बहुत जगह आया है। Like BHU law entrance 2012 में भी same question पूछा था। ऐसा different different exam में तीन चार बार पूछा है। और उसको उठा के 2017 में भी दे दिया। Same question आया थी। The mind of the makers of the Constitution of India is reflected in which of the following? The preamble, only options को jumble किया है, कुछ change किया है। Otherwise same question. So preamble is the answer. Getting me? Mind, philosophy, objectives. Getting me? ऐसा जो भी word आता है, तो that is all preamble. Next question from CDS 2012. The preamble is useful in constitutional interpretation because it uses value-loaded words, contains the real objective and philosophy of the constitution makers. Yes, it contains the real objective and philosophy of the constitution makers. So it is a source of power and limitation. No, it is neither source of power nor limitation of legislature. D gives an exhaustive list of basic features of the constitution. ये तो छोटी paragraph है, तो इसमें कहाँ से exhaustive list है? So B the answer. See how questions are coming. Very basic questions. Hope you are getting me. So this is all what you need to know about preamble, the introduction part. Now we understand the text of preamble. This is also very very important exam point of view. Mein. You have to literally know what is written in preamble. But don't mug up. I will tell you how to remember. Very simple. We don't remember, we understand in fact. First we understand what is the source of authority. What is the source of this? Who made it? We, the people of India. So, hum banaya hai. Of course, the constituent assembly members were elected by people, right? So, we, the people of India. First point is the source, the people of India. Then, nature of state. What kind of state they wanted to make? They wanted to make sovereign. If you see, present day the preamble looks like this. But at the time of making, it was only sovereign, democratic, republic. Sovereign, democratic, republic. If baad mein add hua hai, socialist and secular, these two words were added in the 42nd amendment. Main uski baad mein baat karta hu thodi der ke baad. Pehle itna samajh lijiye. So what kind of state we wanted at that time? Sovereign, democratic, republic. See, what does it mean? If you see, sovereign means completely independent. Externally, India is independent. We have to take some decisions. We will take ourselves. We do not require some third party interference, right? Some other country ka interference nahi chahiye humko. We can take it. See, don't get confused. Hum United Nations ka member hai. It doesn't mean that it is binding on us. See, United Nations ka matlab hi hai na. It is a union of sovereign countries. So, sovereign means independent. Similarly, democratic means the people of India elect their governments at all levels, chahe union government, state or local government, by system of universal adult franchise. Whoever got get 18 years of age can cast his vote, her vote, and we elect, people of India elect representatives of government. That is called democratic. And what is the meaning of republic? The head of state, the head of the state, who is that person? The president of India. So he is also directly or indirectly elected. Means republic means the head of the state is elected. Democratic means all forms of governments are elected. Sovereign means independent. So we wanted this. What is the nature of state we wanted? Sovereign, democratic, republic. Getting me? So baad mein add hua hai socialist and secular. These two words were added later. 42nd amendment mein add hua hai. Socialist ka matlab hai, socialist means social and economic equality. What does it mean? Social equality means there is no discrimination on the basis of caste, color, creed, sex, religion, language, etc. In basic discrimination nahi hona chahiye. Social equality, all are equal. Getting me? Very simple words. No need to mug up. These are not definitions. Just to give you an idea, I am telling. Similarly, economic equality means what? The government should try to, you know, distribute the wealth. That's why tax leta hai, jiski income particular limit se jyada hota hai to, and that money will be spent on, you know, jisko upar spend karna hai, jis schemes pe, uspe spend karta hai. That is what is economic equality. Are you getting what I am saying? So this is what is socialist. And secular means the government or, you know, we do not have, the state has no religion. Getting me? So secularism means equal treatment of all religions by the state. Hope you understand. So what kind of nature of state? Kaisa chahta tha hum? Sovereign, democratic, republic chahta tha. Now 42nd amendment mein two words aur add kiya gaya. Secular and socialist. So now what is the nature of state? Sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic, republic. Hope you understand this. You have to know this also. Now, after moving to this, what are the objectives of the constitution? What is the means, what the constitution is trying to do, what the government should try to do, or what is the objective? Justice. Social justice, economic justice and political justice. ये सारे चीज़ आपको थोड़ा आगे बढ़ेंगे ना, कुछ टॉपिक्स और करना लगेंगे तो तब सब समझ में आएगा. So justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression. ये बार-बार पूछा जाता है इसका order. तो easy to remember, liberty of thought, आप कुछ भी सोच सकता है, express कर सकता है. Thought होगा तो express करेंगे. Thought and expression ये अलग करेंगे. Then belief, you can believe in anything. Belief होगा तो faith होगा, faith होगा तो worship करेंगे. So belief, faith, worship, इसको अलग करेंगे. Now it is very easy. Thought and expression, belief, faith and worship. Liberty of thought and expression, belief, faith and worship. Equality of status and opportunity. Getting me? Opportunity, सबको equal होना चाहिए and status. You see reservations provide कर रहा है government. Doesn't mean that opportunity नहीं दे, I mean equality नहीं है opportunity में, ऐसा मत सोचना. That is, you know, giving privilege to somebody. That is not the one. What I mean here, opportunity में equality का मतलब. We have to समझ में आएगा, don't worry. And to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. Again, one more word is added in the 42nd amendment. That is the word integrity. It was not there. Primarily it was like unity of the nation. Now it is added unity and integrity of the nation. Ye choti exams mein baar baar pucha jata hai. 42nd amendment mein kaun kaun si words add kiya gaya hai. So, teen words. Socialist, secular, integrity. Hope you understand this. So, if you see, and next if you see, what is the date of action? So, in our Constituent Assembly, the 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this constitution. So 26th of November 1949, AB Choti exams ke liye. Sare yaad rakhna hai aapko. Ye text pe bahut baar questions aaye hain aur aata rahenge. Prelims mein in various exams. Simply the source is the people of India. The nature of state is sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic, republic. Socialist and secular were added in 42nd amendment. Objectives are justice, social, economic and political justice, equality of thought and expression, belief, faith and worship. Liberty of thought and expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and opportunity, and to promote fraternity among all, and unity and integrity, right? And humne liya hai 26th November 1949. So this is text of preamble. See how questions come on this. Fraternity means brotherhood. Hope you know this. Like there was a question in 1988. Economic justice as one of the objectives of the Indian Constitution has been provided in law. Economic justice, if you see, it is there in preamble, right? Justice. Kaisa justice the? Economic, political and social. Social, economic, political. Are you getting me? So economic justice is part of preamble. See, we have fundamental right, DPSP, baad mein dekhenge. Otherwise it is DPSP, we baad mein dekhenge. But preamble mein hai. See, pura question abhi nahi pata chala. But question kabhi kabhi aisa ho sakta hai na, do concepts ka mix ko mix karke bhi de sakta hai. Yahan itna to samajh mein aa raha hai na, preamble ki dal. Getting me? 1988. The same question again came in 2013. Same question as it is. Economic justice as one of the objectives of Indian Constitution has been provided in preamble, of course, DPSP. So B answer hota hai. So preamble mein hai. Getting me? Now you see a question from Rajasthan Administration Services 2013. Arrange the sequence in which terms related to liberty appear in the preamble of the Constitution. Liberty of us order maang raha hai. Simple. पहले thought and expression सोचूंगा और बोलूंगा, belief, faith and worship. So thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, B the answer. Hope you are getting me. I am not going fast, I think. So B the answer. Rajasthan में आया है. The same question again came in 2017 civil services with little modification. Which one of the following objectives is not embodied in the preamble to the Constitution of India? C. All are one and the same questions. थोड़ा इधर इधर घुमा के बार बार आते रहता है. That is what I am trying to tell you. If you understand the nature of this exam and what kind of questions are coming in various UPSC conducted exams, you realize how silly this exam is. 40 to 45 questions वैसे देख के आंसर कर सकते हैं आप. Because वही चाहे prelims हो या interview में भी same questions पूछा जाता है. You need to understand first. मैं ये नहीं बोल रहा हूँ सिर्फ प्रीवियस पेपर सॉल्व करके जाओ, कंसेप्ट भी सीखेंगे उसके साथ साथ द वे द क्वेश्चंस आर बीइंग आस्क्ड यू मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड दैट आल्सो. अदरवाइज व्हाट हैपेंड, पेपर सेटअप की आपकी कोई लिंक ही नहीं बन रहा है तो आप कुछ और ही समझ रहे हैं एग्जाम को. एग्जाम ईजी आने के बावजूद बाद में आप समझ नहीं पा रहे हैं. दैट इज वेरी बैड. सी सेम क्वेश्चन ऑलमोस्ट. सो लिबर्टी ऑफ थॉट एंड एक्सप्रेशन है, लिबर्टी ऑफ बिलीफ फेथ एंड वर्शिप है. सो लिबर्टी ऑफ थॉट, लिबर्टी ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन, लिबर्टी ऑफ बिलीफ, इकोनॉमिक लिबर्टी नहीं है. सो बी द आंसर. व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट, इतना सिली क्वेश्चन आ रहा है एग्जाम में. अभी इसी साल का क्वेश्चन, दो क्वेश्चन आया इस टॉपिक से, दोनों देखो कितना बकवास सिली क्वेश्चन है, दोनों किसी से कॉपी करके दिया है. Getting me? It is very easy. This exam is very easy. You need to understand this. Please understand why this is easy. Don't just मानने से कुछ नहीं होगा. आपको समझना है. You have to come across all the previous papers at least. कितने papers होंगे? आप सारे state exams की मेजर करें, at least last 5 years की papers करें, almost 10 state exams. AP, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Rajasthan, Jharkhand, Bihar. You can say West Bengal, Punjab, UP, MP, all these previous papers if you do, 10, 5, 50 papers. Similarly, CDS, NDA, CAPF, CISF, Engineering Services, all these papers. At least 5 papers. So, and last 40 years of IAS papers. If you do this, almost you have 150 papers. But, सारे करने की जरूरत नहीं. बहुत questions उसमें waste होगा. Means, now, they are outdated. So you need to selectively do that. If you can do that, around 4,000-5,000 questions banenge. Agar ye sare questions ek baar dekh liya hota hai to aap, agar topic wise divide karke main provide karunga aapke liye. Once you see this, you realize how silly this exam is. Then you understand, oh, yehi sare questions aapko pata lagega, okay, ye wahan se aisa pucha, kyun pucha aapko pata chalega. Take one more question. 1984 का civil services question. Which one of the following is part of preamble of the Constitution of India? We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic, do hereby adopt, enact, and give to ourselves this constitution. ठीक है? B, we, the members of the parliament. यहाँ किस पे concentrate कर रहे हैं मैं? वे source of authority पे concentrate कर रहे हैं. मैं इसलिए आपको ऐसे डिवाइड करके बताया. Source क्या? People of India. And what is the nature? Sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic. What are the objectives? जस्टिस किस तरह की जस्टिस सोशल इकोनॉमिक पॉलिटिकल लिबर्टी ऑफ थॉट एक्सप्रेशन बिलीफ फेथ एंड वर्शिप सिमिलरली लिबर्टी के बाद क्या था इक्वालिटी किस तरह की इक्वालिटी ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटी एंड स्टेटस स्टेटस एंड अपॉर्चुनिटी एंड टू प्रमोट फ्रेटर्निटी दीज आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स राइट एंड कीपिंग यूनिटी एंड इंटीग्रिटी एंड कब बनाया 26 नवंबर 1946 बस इतना ही समझना है कितने बार क्वेश्चन आया है इसमें मैं सारे क्वेश्चन यहाँ नहीं दिखा रहा हूँ अदरवाइज कम से कम 20-25 टाइम्स आया होगा डिफरेंट डिफरेंट एग्जाम्स में सेम टेक्स्ट याद होगा तो वे क्वेश्चन आंसर कर सकते हैं तो उससे क्या समझ सकते हो आप दैट मीन्स टेक्स्ट ऑफ प्रीएम्बल पे क्वेश्चन फ्रीक्वेंटली आता रहता है सिमिलरली इंट्रोडक्शन दैट मीन्स व्हाट इज इट कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन फ्रेमर्स का माइंड है उसका जो फिलॉसफी है उसका ऑब्जेक्टिव है द रियल गोल है द प्रीफेस है द आइडेंटिटी कार्ड है और यू नो द रियल ऑब्जेक्टिव है गोल है जो भी है ये सब एक वर्ड समझना है एंड और बात करेंगे यूएस पहले बार इंट्रोड्यूस किया है फिर और बात करेंगे हमारा 1919 एक्ट में भी है 1935 में नहीं है बस इतना ही है ऐसा कैटेगरी करके समझ लेंगे ना याद रखना भी इजी होता है और जब भी क्वेश्चन आएगा आप समझ भी सकते हैं और आंसर भी कर सकता है दैट इज व्हाट यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड सो ये इज द आंसर ए में पीपल ऑफ इंडिया की बात कर रहा है बी में बोल रहा है कि मैं मेंबर्स ऑफ पार्लियामेंट सी में बोल रहा है कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट असेंबली डी में बोल रहा है नन ऑफ देम सो पीपल ऑफ इंडिया इज करेक्ट ए इज द करेक्ट वन लास्ट कांसेप्ट प्रीएम्बल वर्सेस सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने क्या बोला है इसके मामले में इफ यू सी बेरबरी केस में एक केसेस के बारे में मैं अलग वीडियो में बताऊंगा जब टाइम आएगा तो अभी नाउ वी डोंट इन्वॉल्व इनटू दैट वी डोंट गेट डाइवर्टेड एंड बेरबरी केस में बोला है सुप्रीम कोर्ट बेरबरी एक जगह है बंगाल में जब ईस्टर्न पाकिस्तान दैट मींस बांग्लादेश में कुछ एक ग्रुप ऑफ विलेजेस था कुछ विलेजेस बांग्लादेश में चले गए मींस पाकिस्तान में चले गए उस टाइम के बांग्लादेश और पाकिस्तान एंड कुछ इंडिया में था देयर वाज अ क्वेश्चन ऑफ एक्सचेंजिंग दिस एंड ऑल विद डिटेल में हम कहीं और देखेंगे सो उस केस में सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने बोला था प्रीएम्बल वाज नॉट पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन सो इन बेरबरी केस सुप्रीम कोर्ट सेड दैट द प्रीएम्बल गिव्स जनरल आइडिया बिहाइंड द वेरियस प्रोविजंस इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड हेंस ओपिनियन दैट द प्रीएम्बल वाज नॉट ए पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ये अगेन आईएएस के लिए नहीं छोटी मोटी एग्जाम में पूछता रहता है इन विच केस सुप्रीम कोर्ट हेल्ड दैट प्रीएम्बल वाज नॉट पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऐसा आएगा तो आंसर है बेरबरी केस में बोला है इट इज नॉट इट वाज नॉट पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन बाद में एक और केस आया है केशवानंद भारती केस उस केस में बोला है इट इज पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ये केशवानंद भारती वर्सेस केरला स्टेट ये केस क्या है अलग से देखेंगे इंपॉर्टेंट केसेस है 6-7 केसेस उसकी बात हम अलग से करेंगे नाउ इतना माइंड में रखना केशवानंद भारती केस में क्या बोला है प्रीएम्बल इज पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन क्योंकि वहां क्वेश्चन आया है क्या प्रीएम्बल को अमेंड कर सकता है तो मैंने बोला है यस इट कैन बी अमेंडेड बिकॉज इट इज पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन सुप्रीम कोर्ट के अदालती है जो खुद का ओपिनियन को बदल सकते हैं तो पहले बोला इट वाज नॉट पार्ट बाद में बोला है इस केस में इट इज पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन होप यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट आई एम सेइंग सो इन 1973 केशवानंद भारती केस ही टोल्ड दैट इट इज पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इवन वन मोर केस एलआईसी ऑफ इंडिया केस इन 1995 आल्सो सुप्रीम कोर्ट हेल्ड दैट प्रीएम्बल इज पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन दैट मींस एट प्रेजेंट अकॉर्डिंग टू सुप्रीम कोर्ट इट इज पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन टुडे Are you getting me? पहले बोला था बेरबरी में नहीं है बाद में केशवानंद भारती में अपना ओपिनियन बदल दिया और बोला है इट वाज पार्ट एंड इट इज पार्ट एंड आफ्टर दैट एलआईसी ऑफ इंडिया केस में भी दोबारा बोला इट इज पार्ट एंड नाउ इट इज पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन इवन दिस क्वेश्चन वाज डिस्कस्ड इन द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट असेंबली आल्सो एट द टाइम ऑफ मेकिंग whether preamble should be part of the constitution or not they also have voted for it being part of the constitution So the present opinion of the Supreme Court is in consonance with the founding fathers, that means the constitution makers. So are you getting me? Constitution makers भी यही बोला था preamble is part of the constitution. बट बाद में बिरबारी केस में सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने बोला इट इज नॉट पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. अगेन केशवानंद भारती केस एंड इवन एलआईसी ऑफ इंडिया केस में बोला है इट इज पार्ट ऑफ द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. टुडे इट इज पार्ट ऑफ कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. इट इज अकॉर्डिंग इट इज एग्जैक्टली द सेम एज व्हाट कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट असेंबली आल्सो हैज एक्सेप्टेड. आर यू गेटिंग मी? Now the amendment. So in this case, Keshwanand Bharti case, Supreme Court held that it can be amended because it is part of the constitution. So how many times it has been amended? Question आ सकता है, एक statement दे सकता है. Preamble has been amended till now only 3 times, or it has not been amended yet. ऐसा कोई भी statement आ सकता है. दोनों गलत है. It has been amended only once. So the preamble was amended only once so far. That is in 42nd amendment. 1976 में ये amendment बहुत important amendment है, उसके बाद में बात करेंगे. So 42nd amendment में it was amended only once. What was the amendment also? You know, 3 words were introduced. That is socialist and secular in the nature of the state. Similarly, integrity, unity and integrity बन गया. Integrity was added. So the 3 words were introduced in the 42nd amendment, and this is the only time the preamble has been amended. Are you getting me? Now you see a question from APPSC 2012. In Berbari case, the Supreme Court said that preamble. ये बार-बार बहुत छोटी-मोटी एग्जाम्स में आता रहता है. So Berbari में क्या बोला? केशवानंद भारती में क्या बोला? ये दोनों important याद रखिए. Berbari में बोला it is not part of constitution. So B the answer. So A part of constitution गलत. B not part of the constitution सही. C main part of the constitution गलत. D insignificant. So B the answer. Getting me? Similarly, a question from again same paper. It was decided by the Supreme Court that preamble can be amended in. So it was decided in Keshwanand Bharti case. Keshwanand Bharti case mein bola it can be amended and it is part of the constitution. So D the answer. Are you getting me? So this is all about this simple topic preamble. Hope you have understood. Only 30 minutes topic and important for various exams. Thanks for watching. Bye.